There are three main things that makes literature review time consuming. Looking for the right literature. Sometimes it takes a long time for you to get the right literature for you based on the topic that you are searching for. And also after having those literature, reading through, selecting the right ones, or synthesizing so that you'll be able to present studies that have been done related to your topic in a synthesized form, sometimes very difficult. And this is where consensus come in to help. So what is consensus? It's an AI-powered search engine and search for articles or literature that are related to your topic based on the question that you ask the system. And then it can synthesize, giving you ideas about how to present the literature that you have identified. When you go to consensus, this is what you see. You can ask any question related to your topic and you'll be able to get relevant information about your topic. As you can see here, synthesize. It can help you to compare and contrast, getting an idea about what is going on in relation to your topic. So synthesize is not summarizing. It goes beyond just summarizing. It's trying to compare and contrast study that has been done related to your topic. And Copilot also help in providing you answers to questions that you are concerned about or related to the topic. So that's what I like, these two functions. And you'll see how powerful this one is going to help you to literature that you need for you to run and do your literature review. So imagine you want to find out the relationship between acculturative stress and psychological well-being. And you want to find out the relationship and also want to see what has been done concerning these two issues. How do you do that? You copy this question and let's go to consensus. And then you put your question here. And you press on enter. What is the relationship between acculturative stress and psychological well-being? It's more of an open-ended question, right? So the consensus method will not be able to say that yes or no. So if you want to find articles that support or disagree with a specific question, then you have to make it a close-ended. Like, you see how consensus has suggested how you can make it a close-ended. Before we click on this, I just want to see what the system has provided to you. So I type, what is the relationship between acculturative stress and psychological well-being? And you see that the system has identified and analyzed 10 articles, not only identified, it has analyzed 10 articles and it's giving you a brief summary about the relationship. And then here, consensus meter, this one tells you articles that it will say, yes, there's a relationship, will say, no, there's no relationship. The reason why it did not generate is that the question here is open-ended. If you want yes or no answer, then you have to make the question close-ended so that you'll be able to get articles that says no, there's no relationship, and also articles that say yes, there's a relationship, right? So the consensus meter didn't work here because of how you put the question, but I think the result is very useful information that you can work on. Copilot, 10 articles has been analyzed and giving you a synthesis of the article. So as you can see here, a brief information that related to the article that will give you an idea about how to synthesize your relevant article that you have identified. When you move down here, you have the list of all the 10 articles, how many times it has been cited. You have the year and the DOI. Is a unique number that is associated with a specific article, right? And also the journal. You can see the Asian American Journal of Psychology. And then it also tells you this type of study. Here it tells you that it's an observational study. You can also even click on the study snapshot and it will give you brief information about the study. You can see that there's a population here, sample size, and also gives you information about the method used and the outcome. How amazing if you can even export the article as CSV, Excel spreadsheet, and you can also export this information and send it to any reference management tool that you are using. You can easily cite. You click on here, you can have different citations, formats that you want. I like APA, and then you copy that. You can share this article. If you want more information about the article, you can click on it to give you, open the article, and then you can see all the information that you need to know. Another great observation here, it tells you the strength or the level of influence of that this article was published. So you can see that if it's Q1, it means that it's one of the most influential journal in the domain, right? So you see how it tells you the quality of the article. If you want to get access, you can click on full access. Sometimes you have to check your institution and see whether you can get a full access, or sometimes you just copy and search it through maybe Google to get access to it. So you can click on get access. If you don't get it, then you have to find a way, maybe check with your school or your school library to get access to the articles. It gives you the key takeaway. This is awesome. It gives you a lot of information that will help you to make informed decision whether you want to use this article for your literature review. This is a game changer. It will reduce the time that you need to use to look for the right literature and analyze those literature and then write your literature review. This AI tool will be so helpful for you if you can get access to it. So let's try. Let me go back a little bit. So when you go down here, you can click here and export in CSV. Now I have it. I can open so that you can see. So as you can see here, it has the title. It provides you the title of the 10 articles, takeaway, author, year, how many times it has been cited, abstract, and also the link to the article. So you can also save this information. Another thing that I wanted to show to you that, as I said, if you want the consensus meter to work, then the question that you have to put here should be closed-ended. One example is, you see how this one is open-ended and the system suggested this one for you. Does occultative stress affect mental health? Let's click on that. So as you can see, 18 articles were analyzed, or 18 papers were analyzed. 100% all of the 18 articles support the fact that occultative stress affects mental health, right? So you see, and it gives a summary. And as you can see here, a synthesis of the 10 articles, and then you can export. We can try another question and see what we're going to get. Is mental health condition curable? This question is a closed-ended question. The answer might be yes, no, or possibly, right? As you can see here. So let's see what we're going to get. 8 papers were analyzed, and you can see the little summary here. It says that we don't have enough information to run the consensus meters, but still is very usable too. Another thing that you may have to think about is you can also filter. How do you filter? You click on filter here, and if you want only 2024 articles, so you can also filter by year of publication. You can also see whether it's open access. You can also filter by methodology and even filter by sample size and also the kind of journal. And then click on apply and search. And that's how we do it. You don't have to only ask a closed-ended question. You can also add open-ended question. One question that you can ask is that, can you provide me articles related to mental health stigma? You see how you can ask the system to provide you something, right? So as you can see here, it has provided us information, and you can click here to go to some of the articles. And when you go down, there are a list of articles that has been provided, right? It gives you a lot of information about each of the articles to help you to make informed decision. That's what I love about this. Another thing that you may want to do, if you have GPT Plus, you can easily click on this one and it will take you to custom GPT called consensus, or another way of looking for it is when if you have GPT Plus, you can easily go to explore and then you scroll down and here is one of the trending GPTs. So you can just click on consensus and then start chatting with the system, right? You can ask the system any question that you want and it will be able to answer you. So we can try and see, let's try to ask a question. What are the strategies for addressing mental health stigma? It's now searching consensus. You click on allow to give the system to go and search information there. And then you can see that it has provided you some information, community involvement, education. And as you can see here, there's a link here that you can click on and get access to the articles that you need. Sometimes when you try to click on it, it doesn't work that way. Let me see, maybe it hasn't finished providing all the information. So we can wait and see. Then we'll be able to click on and see whether it will work. Yes, the links work. So you see how when you click on it, it takes you back to consensus and it provides you all the information about the article that will help you to make informed decision. So you can click on this consensus app and it will take you there. It doesn't take you to all the articles. You have to click on individual ones and then take you to the articles. So that's why sometimes you just have to go straight to the article and ask the system questions so that you can get what you want, a list of all the articles that may be relevant concerning your study. You can also tell the system to suggest some topics for you. So can you suggest topics I can write about when working on my literature review? The topic be related to the mental health. So you see how it has provided me some topic and also resources. It's amazing. If you are doing the traditional way looking for topics, it will take you a long time. But see how, with the help of an AI tool, you'll be able to get access to the information that you need to start writing or working on your literature review. I've put a link of this website in the video description, so you can click on it in case you want to get access to this wonderful software. You can use this promo code Philip20 to get 20% off. Thank you for your time. If you have any question, feel free to put in the comment section. I'll be happy to address them for you. I appreciate your time.